Come friends, in this new video we will discuss about an important theorem of number theory, and it is called as fundamental theorem of arithmetic. The statement of this theorem shows that if n is an integer greater than 1, then it can be expressed as a product of prime numbers. See that the statement of and fundamental statement of the fundamental theorem of arithmetic: every positive integer n greater than 1 can be expressed as a product of prime numbers, and this representation is unique apart from the order in which they occurs. Look at the proof of this theorem. Proof: if n is prime, then we have nothing to prove in this theorem. We have proved already that this statement is true since it is expressed as a product of prime. So if n is composite, if n is a composite number, then n has divisor, n has divisors. Suppose D is a divisor of n, n has a divisor, then list all the divisors. If we list all these divisors, okay, and look, n is a composite number, n is greater than 1, its divisor is also positive. So the list of divisor is of positive integer. Then by well ordering principle, we can apply well ordering principle. By well ordering principle, it has a smallest number. Principle: the list has a smallest number. The list has smallest integer, say P1 is a smallest. Okay, that means P1 is a divisor of n, and this P1 is a smallest. If P1 is not smallest, and if P1 is a smallest, then the P1 must be a prime number. Now if P is not prime, if P1 is not prime, let us check the possibility. What happen if P1 is not prime? Then P1 has a divisor. Suppose Q1 is a divisor of P1. That means that this Q1 is less than P1, and this Q1 is also divisor of n. Q1 is a divisor of P1, P1 is a divisor of n, and this means that this Q1 is a divisor of n. Then what we get? We have a smallest divisor than P1, okay, of n. This is a contradiction to our assumption, to our supposition that the P1 is the smallest divisor. Okay, so this is contradiction because we have assumed that P1 is not prime, and obviously this shows that this P1 must be a prime number. Okay, now what we have taken? We have taken n is composite number. If n is composite number, it has a divisor, and from that divisors list we have chosen the smallest, and that smallest number is a P1, and that P1 must be a prime number. Okay, but then what we get now? Here we have taken this P1 is a divisor of n. This implies that the n equal to P1 into N1, where 1 is less than equal to N1 and less than N. Again, there are two possibilities. This N1 is a prime, or this N1 is a composite. Repeat this process with N1. Means if it is a prime number, then we have proved N is a product of two primes, P1 and N1, and proof is complete. If N1 is a composite, N1 is a composite, then there exists a prime P2 such that this P2 is a divisor of N1, and we have N3 where we have N2 where this 1 less than equal to N2 less than N1. Okay, so we continue this process, and arrive at, if N2 again a prime number, then we have N is equal to P1 into P2 into N2, all are prime numbers. So we have proved the theorem. Now if N2 is a composite, then N2 is equal to P3 into N3, 1 less than equal to N3 less than N2. Okay. Look at this, where N is greater than N1, N1 is greater than N2, N2 is greater than N3. So this is a decreasing sequence, and it cannot go beyond 1 since all are positive numbers. That means the process terminates after some stage. Suppose that it terminates at k-1. That is, k-1 is a prime number, and let us call it as pk. Then we have N is equal to p1 into p2 dash dash pk. That is, N is expressed as product of prime numbers p1, p2 and pk. Okay, I hope you have get this. What we have done? If p is a composite number, it has divisor. Choose the smallest one. That smallest one must be prime number. Then we get that N equal to P1 into N1. If N1 is a prime, then we have proved N is a product of primes. If N1 is a composite, then again repeating the same process, we get N1 equal to P2 into N2. But then P1 into P2 into N2. Okay, so the process is continue, and we arrive at the prime numbers P1, P2 and PK. Now let us prove that this product is a unique product. Suppose that we have two compositions, N equal to, one is P1, P2, PR and other is Q1, Q2 and QS. All are primes, P1, P2, PN, PR and Q1, Q2, QS are all primes. So this implies that P1 is a divisor of Q1, Q2 and QS. Okay, but by corollary, this means that P1 is a divisor of P1 is a divisor of QK for some K. But this means that P1 is greater than equal to Q1. This is for QK, for some K, whatever may be. That means P1 is equal to QK for some K. We have proved if QK is a prime, then P1 is equal to QK. But this P1 then greater than equal to Q1. But again, Q1 is also prime. That means Q1 is a divisor of P1, P2, P2 and PR. Okay, this implies that Q1 is equal to PK for some K. Then this means that Q1 is greater than equal to P1. So these two inequality we conclude that P1 is equal to Q1. If P1 is equal to Q1, we cancel this P1 and Q2. Similarly, we cancel P1 and P2. dash dash. If r is less than s, that means 1, 2 up to r, r plus 1 up to s. So first r number, first q r will be cancelled, and we have, this is possibility if r is less than s, we have 1 is equal to q r plus 1 into q r plus 2 dash dash q s. What it means? These are the prime numbers, and product of primes is equal to 1. These are the integers, and product of integers is equal to 1. This is an absurd case. Okay, this is not possible. This is impossible. It cannot be possible product of prime numbers equal to 1, and hence this is a wrong assumption. R is less than s. So what it means? This means that r equal to s. If r equal to s, then we can cancel every prime, and we get p1 equal to q1, p2 equal to q2, dash dash pr is equal to qr. So this means that this p1, p2, pr, this is an unique representation of the number n. Every composite number is then expressed as a product of prime numbers.
Hello guys, thank you for watching video.